In this presentation, we will consider one special problem related to Floyd's triangle. So let's get started. First of all, let's consider some basics. What is Floyd's triangle? Floyd's triangle, named after a computer scientist, Robert W. Floyd, is a right-angled triangular array of natural numbers. It is filled by natural numbers, consecutively starting with 1 in the top left corner. Like for example, suppose we have a Floyd's triangle with 5 rows. Then a Floyd's triangle with 5 rows may look like this. Starting from the 1 in the top left corner, then the rest of the natural numbers will get printed consecutively in a right-angled triangle. This is how a Floyd's triangle may look like. Okay? Now, after understanding how a Floyd's triangle looks like, let's try to understand how we can write a code in C language which can print Floyd's triangle on the screen. Suppose user wants to print this triangle on the screen. Then as a developer, I need to ask user how many number of rows you want in your Floyd's triangle. Therefore, I ask to enter the number of rows. Then user may provide 5. Then I will store this value 5 inside this rows variable. If you observe this triangle carefully, this triangle starts from 1, right? Therefore, I know that I need to print 1 first on the screen, right? So I initialize the value of n by 1. This n is nothing but depicting the natural numbers that we want to print in our Floyd's triangle. Now again, if you observe this triangle carefully, you can clearly see in the first row only one element is there, and the second row you have 2 elements, in the third row you are having 3 elements, in the fourth row you are having 4 elements, and the fifth row you are having 5 elements. This simply means that number of elements in a row is dependent on the row number, right? Therefore, I need a for loop which runs from 1 to the number of rows, and then I need another for loop inside this for loop which runs from 1 to the row number. Here I depicts the row number, as when I is equals to 1, then this loop must run from 1 to 1. That means this loop runs only one time and it will simply print only one value on the screen. And if suppose I is equals to 3, then this loop runs from 1 to 3. This means this loop will print only 3 elements in the third row, right? And now we know what we want inside this for loop. That is, we want to print the value of n on the screen, and we need to increment the value of n as well. After this for loop, we need to print a new line. Why I need this new line? Because after printing all the elements of a single row, we need to come to the next row. For this, we need a new line, right? Now, let's try to imagine how this code works. As rows variable contain 5, therefore this loop runs from 1 to 5, right? Starting from 1, as 1 is less than 5, condition is satisfied, we come inside this for loop, and as you can see, this loop runs from 1 to 1, that means in the first row only one element will get printed, right? As n equals to 1, therefore 1 will get printed in the first row. After that, we simply increment the value of n. Now n becomes 2. Then after printing all the elements of this row, we come to the new line because of this slash n. Then we come at this point. We simply increment the value of I now becomes 2, as 2 is less than 5, therefore condition is satisfied. We come inside this for loop again and we run this loop 2 times because this loop runs from 1 to 2. And in the first iteration, it will simply print 2 on the screen, and then after that, it will print 3. Then after that, we come to the next row. Now you can easily imagine how this code works for each and every row, right? Now let's try to execute this code in code blocks. Let's execute this code. Suppose we want to print 6 rows in our triangle. Then our Floyd's triangle looks like this. Now suppose we want to print 10 rows. Then this is how our Floyd's triangle looks like, right? Okay friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this presentation.
Thank you.